Namaskar students, let's start digestion in human beings. Humans are omnivorous organisms. They have a well-developed digestive system like other multicellular animals. The complex food eaten by humans need to be broken down into simpler forms before it reaches the cell. To carry out this process, humans have a well-developed alimentary canal. Here is a very simple diagram is given of alimentary canal. You can go through it. It starts from the mouth and ends with the anus. So what are the other parts? Mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, rectum and anus, with some accessory glands that are salivary glands, gallbladder, liver, pancreas. Now a human's digestion begins from the process ingestion, where in the mouth. Then is a digestion in mouth, stomach and small intestine. Absorption in small intestine and large intestine. Then is the assimilation in tissues all over the body. And the last, that is ejection or elimination, in the last part of the large intestine, that is rectum. Now here we can see the function of each part of alimentary canal in very short, and then we will go in detail. Now the alimentary canal starts with the mouth or buccal cavity. Now what is its function? Mastication, lubrication, digestion, pharynx and esophagus, that helps in the swallowing of the food, and this esophagus pass the food from the mouth to stomach. The stomach, some digestion, small intestine, most digestion and absorption, large intestine, some absorption, rectum, packaging, and then the glands like salivary glands secretes the salivary amylase that helps in the partial digestion of starch. Then the liver that produces bile, it helps in the digestion of fat, and then pancreas that produces many digestive enzymes. Now let's move to in the detail of the functioning of each part. Let's start with the mouth or buccal cavity. The buccal cavity contains teeth, tongue and salivary glands. The teeth, we know that we have four different types of teeth: to cut, to chew and to grind the food. They are the incisors, canine and molars and premolars. Now what do they do? They used to help in the chewing the food and converts it into the very smaller pieces. Second is the salivary gland. What they do? They used to secrete saliva. Saliva is a fluid that contains the enzymes that is called salivary amylase. They also contain water and some salts. Now what is the function of the salivary amylase? They used to partially digest the starch into maltose. What are the other functions of saliva? Let us discuss. It mixes and lubricates the food thoroughly. The saliva, you know, moistens the inner lining of oral cavity and the surface of the tongue, that helps in the swallowing of the food. The third part of the buccal cavity is the tongue. Now what is the function of the tongue? It helps in the swallowing of the food. It also contains the taste buds, so we get the taste of the food with those taste buds. Now next is the pharynx. Now pharynx is a common passage for food and the air that we during the breathing we enter. Now this food passes from pharynx to this esophagus. This is also called the food pipe. This is a muscular structure. Now it no digestion takes place over here, but its main function is to pass the food from the mouth to the stomach. Now how it passes? Okay, the lining of the food pipe has muscles that contract rhythmically in order to push the the soft and moist food towards the stomach. These special rhythmic waves of contraction are called peristaltic movement or peristalsis. In fact, that peristaltic movements occur in the entire alimentary canal, which help in smooth movement of food. Now food is no longer called the food, it is called bolus, enters to the stomach. Now what is stomach? It is a large J-shaped muscular bag like structure located below the diaphragm. Okay. Food is passed from the esophagus into the stomach. At the junction between the stomach and this esophagus, and the stomach and the small intestine, there are sphincters present over there which controls the movement of food. Now you can ask, what are these sphincters? Sphincters are actually circular muscles or muscular structures which control the movement of substances through them. Normally, it remains closed. When movement is required, they open. So, in this way, the many such sphincters are present in the alimentary canal, like when the food moves from the stomach to the small intestine, and then from the small intestine to the large intestine. Here, from rectum to the anus, all these sphincters are present. Now, what is the function of the stomach during this digestive process?